Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. Today we'll be creating vector water surface bubbles in Illustrator. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to create a glossy bubble by designing two different forms of bubbles. Then we'll look at how to use gradient tool to add effects, highlights and shades. Then we'll create a water surface scene by arranging the design we have created. So let's begin with the tutorial. Open a new Illustrator document and draw a circle using the ellipse tool. Now, we'll modify the shape using the direct selection tool. So, select the anchor points and rotate the angle using the handles. And also, change the position of the anchor points to give an organic look. Next, we'll fill this up with gradient color. So, select the gradient tool and under gradient panel, apply the color. Change the right slider color to light blue. You can obtain the color by adjusting the RGB sliders. For this, I'll just type out the color code #69BCFF. After that, change the type to radial. Let's increase the radius and shift the center point to the corner. The center point where the color is white represents the light intensity. Next, create a duplicate of the circle using the shortcut Command or Control C to copy and Command or Control F to paste in front. Now, we'll create one more duplicate by pressing the Alt key and with mouse click and drag. Scale down the size and place it a little bit upward, leaving an arc shape on the bottom. Now, select the top circle and the second circle and apply minus friend option from the pathfinder. Now let's change the color of the gradient. So go through gradient panel and change the left slider color. Let's put the value #00AEE. For the right slider, we'll put the value #003789 to give deep blue color. Now change the type to radial and edge the gradient using the gradient tool. Next, select the circle and create a copy on top using the shortcut Command or Control C to copy and Command or Control F to paste in front. Now draw a shape using the pen tool covering top half portion of the circle. Then select the shape and the circle and apply minus friend to subtract the top portion. For this, let's give different gradient color. For the right slider, let's give the value #0267C3. Now, edge the color using the gradient tool. Keep the base dark and the top lighter. Then, bring the arc shape on the top using the option Bring to Front. Next, with the Alt pressed, click and drag to create a duplicate of the shape. Then, with the direct selection tool, edge the handles to give narrow ends on both sides. Now, create a duplicate of the second shape and subtract the top object from it using the minus friend option from the pathfinder. This will leave us a wavy shaped strip. Now, we'll change the gradient color. So, for the left slider, apply blue color from the swatches. And for the right slider, put the value #003781. Then adjust the gradient direction. Now, we'll add highlights. So create a duplicate of this strip and modify the shape. For this, apply white color. Next, we'll add more details. So create two shapes on both sides using the pen tool. For this, we'll apply the same color as the strip. So copy the color using the eye picker. Then adjust the gradient direction using the gradient tool. Next, create more shapes to add more details. apply the same gradient colors. Now, the next thing is to give Gaussian blur to each of the objects. To apply, go to Effects, Blur, Gaussian Blur. For this highlight, I'm going to give 2.7 pixel radius. In the same way, set the blur value of each of the shapes. Next, let's create a few more shapes for highlight. Click and drag the pan tool to draw out perfect curves. Now the first thing we're gonna do is to give Gaussian blur to each of the shapes. 3.5 pixel for the center and the top, and 4.8 pixel for the lower one. Change the layer mode to color dodge, overlay and screen for each of the three shapes. Now we'll add a sparkling effect. To create that, we'll use the star tool. Click on the blank area to open the attributes and increase the points to around 24. Then click OK. This will create a shape. Delete it and click and drag to create a new shape. Use Ctrl key to vary the inner radius of the star shape. After this, place it on top corner of the bubble. We'll apply white gradient color. So change the right slider color to white and reduce its opacity to 0. Now we'll do final adjustments of each of the elements to get a nice design. In the same way, we'll create one more bubble, but this time its shapes will be little different. Since its shapes is little different from the previous shape, the details we are adding are little different. But the concept and the process are same. We'll create shades, highlights and glossy effect. Draw out all of the shapes with basic color. Then to apply the color to the shapes, pick up the color from the previous bubble using the eye picker tool. Use gradient tool to adjust each of the gradient color individually. For this bubble design, we are adding much more highlighted shapes to give more glossy look. Adding small and tiny details brings out more realistic look to the design. Once we are completed editing the colors, select each of the shapes and apply Gaussian blur. Set the blur values as per your requirement. Keep on working on the design until it feels right. Add more shapes if needed. Lastly, add the sparkling shape which was created using the star tool, and our second bubble is ready to use. Now, we are going to create a scene for the surface bubbles. So create outer rectangle using the rectangle tool. Then using the pan tool, draw a wave curve. Give a stroke color and remove the fill color. Now select both curve and the rectangle and divide the shape using the shape builder tool. Fill the top half with light blue gradient color and set the center point near the left. For the second half, apply deep blue gradient color. You can pick up the color from the previous bubble design. Keep the lower portion dark and the upper lighter. Now we'll add thin line on the water surface. So select the second shape and drag it down with the alt pressed. Leave a thin area in between. Now select the middle shape and apply deep blue color. In the same way, we'll create one more thin layer and apply blue color. Now we're gonna do the arrangement of the bubble on the surface. Usually when you see a bubbles on the water surface, they are randomly arranged. There is no order. So we're gonna do the same here. Let's do the arrangement as per our perspective. Use both big and small bubbles to balance the design. When you scale down the bubbles, you may lose the details. So make sure to reduce the blur value of each of the individual shapes. Once you are done with the scene, import it to Photoshop to do color correction and add depth of field. We'll use brightness and contrast adjustment layer to add little contrast and hue and saturation to give little greenish tone to the bubbles. Now to add depth of field, go to Filter, Blur Gallery, Tilt Shift and adjust the range. We'll give focus to the surface bubbles and as it goes down, it defocused. Finally, we have completed designing surface water bubbles using Illustrator and Photoshop. During the process, we have seen the process to create a glossy bubbles and use it to create an effective scene. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.